All right, we are continuing where we left off last time. This is a grazing grounds. I feel like the oxen don't really get to rest a whole lot. They are refreshed, but our hygiene is not. I actually am very curious about this. Gain repair items. Is that going to be another one of those like wagons where, you can risk taking parts, but shit might go wrong, crush you, like in that story. Oh God, I forget what it was called. It's like where this dude discovers this like ore vein, a golden ore vein, and he like is chipping away at it. And it's like, will you quit or will the rock give way under your chipping? Fellow travelers, I beseech you, stop and tender assistance to this humble servant of the Lord. My wagon wheels come undone, you see. Might one of you be so kind as to examine it for me? I don't want to replace his wheel. Why can't I just look at it? Say you have nothing to give. The priest watches dolefully as the party wordlessly trundles along. Am I a bad person? Like how we regained. You know what? I'm already on strenuous. Let's go back to meager rations, which is 12 pounds a day. We are getting a bit about food. Yeah, it's this again. Go for an axle. Let's have David try it. The axles, yeah. Okay, so it shifted. His morale went up. While inspecting the wagon, yeah, we found some coffee beans, three coffee. I don't like that it shifted. One shift is enough. We are going to just take what we got. So we are going to move on. We can only go to a hunting ground, and it's probably about time. We need some pelts too. Like, clicking these doesn't count as like hunting. Like, I don't know. I guess it's just for like experience. Rabbits. A bison lies in the dirt beside the trail, unmoving. It doesn't appear to have any external wounds or evidence of sickness, at least at a quick glance. However, further investigation may be necessary to determine the safety of any meat. We're gonna investigate. Who should investigate the carcass? Morgan. Morgan holds her breath and investigates the carcass. She can see nothing external to suggest the meat is unsafe and concludes it is likely the bison simply perished of old age. With a little time, the carcass could be butchered and greatly aid in the party's meat supplies. You know, I would, but I'm going to a hunting ground anyway. And I don't want to risk any sort of intestinal or disease or whatever. The party decides to leave the carcass to the crows. I thought that said cows at first, and I was confused. Okay. Uh-oh. I got to change somebody's clothes. Morgan's. Okay. Let me get this wagon repaired. I'm gonna have Ambrose do it. I believe that the adventurer, which is what he is, can carry more meat than anybody else. Damn it. Oh my God. Damn it. I probably should have taken another shot. Oh, fucking bastard. I wish she would have been a deer. 140 pounds of food. I love that little jumping animation they do. It looks so silly, but I don't know. I guess it's probably some kind of nostalgia. Only enough to carry 125 pounds back. Yeah, we are going to obtain pelts. Five pelts. Alright. This wagon, dude. Jesus Christ, repack. I need to start trying to use some of these items. So thirsty. Alright, our water is running low. Let's go back to filling. We're gonna keep it strenuous, though. We're close to Independence Rock. It's like we're one frickin' day. I'm not risking it. Deal with it. And we gotta ration what we got left. Okay, well. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and use a harmonica. I don't know why I keep that. Isn't our energy pretty... Oh, no, we could actually use it. Let's continue. This music is calming. It's about time for that wagon to start effing up some more. Getting some hills here. Have we made it? It's a fort we're going to, right? Before the mountains. Or was it? Oh, whatever. We'll find out what it is. It is definitely some location. So far we've managed to stave off death and disaster pretty well for ourselves. The party finally arrives at Independence Rock, and we made it before Independence. Let's carve our names in that bit. A foreboding, sprawling monolith stretching hundreds of feet into the air. The rock is smooth, barring, of course, the carved names and initials of previous travelers. Some among the party may take some satisfaction in doing similarly. Oh yeah, we got some, well... All right, let's talk to somebody. We got an exclamation here. All right, what do you got for me, Albert? You got a fiddle? Carved your name into the rock yet? Most travelers seem to have made a habit of it. Letting the world know they were here, I suppose. Carve name. Party clambers up the side of the rock, finding a blank space on the cliff face with a hunting knife. They take turns engraving their names deep into the granite, etching the party's passing for the centuries. The party feels uplifted by the experience. Can I get an oxen to make up for that one? Oh, Big Louie, you beautiful man. Alright, let's trade him 2 pelts because we have quite a number. Offers 2 clothes, you say. What can I give you for him? We're going to go ahead and go with the pelts. We're going to move on from Independence Rock. Where to next? Parting of the ways. An otherwise uninteresting stretch of land. This location splits the trail between the sublet cutoff and the trail to Fort Bridger. Gotta go to Fort Bridger. That is where we are going to go for Lewis. I would like to acquire some more pelts. So we're going to go there. As the majestic Independence Rock fades into the distance, the party looks ahead on their next challenge. Really need some frickin' look at this wagon condition down. What is that? Berries. I don't know about that color of berry. David stops by the side of the trail, examining a small plant covered in tiny blue-hued berries. These are Oregon grapes, inedible despite their name, but imbued with potent healing properties. David plucks some in hopes of treating future illness or injury. God damn. Yeah, 3 more herbal remedies. God, I love him. Even though he's a negative dude. Oh, shit! The wagon bed and canopy have been damaged by the rough trail. While nothing is broken completely this time, the party should consider repairing the wagon before things get worse. Who should attempt to repair the wagon? Ambrose, the most talented at it. Okay, so he improved it by a couple. It's hard work, but Ambrose repairs some of the damage to the wagon. All right, let's try to repack. I got quite a bit more space after repairing some. Oh, we're replacing parts. That's how. Okay. We are definitely gonna... Oh, God. Morgan, or Evie, is starting to stink. Stinky girl. Some new clothes on! We're going with Ambrose again. Oh, this looks beautiful, I think. Damn it. There we go. That'll be quite a number of pelts. We got 150 pounds. We are going to attempt, yeah, 8 pelts. Pelts. All right. We cannot fish, so we're going to go to the campsite where we can tell stories. I don't know if you can see those achievements. Yeah. Okay, we got $65. Still should be over there. Fox spotted. Oh, wait, no, that's for me clicking on the fox. Ambrose spots a young sapling on the side of a trail. If cut and properly stripped, it might serve as a strong wagon tongue, but it'll take some time. Who should cut the sapling? We're gonna go with David, since tries to cut and strip the sapling after a few hours. It's evident it won't hold up. The rigors of being wagon tongue. The project is abandoned. Damn. Oh well. I was just hoping to like get his skill up a little bit more, since it's like not an emergency. Parting of the ways. Oh wait, yeah. We're still a ways away from that. Set up camp. We are gonna tell stories. Okay, yeah. That is so useful. I'd like to get pelts to sell, actually. So we're gonna keep on going for hunting. Speaking of hunting, how's our bullets? We got 33 bullets. The wagon. The fucking wagon, dude. Repack. Fortunately, space is looking pretty okay. Our wagon isn't in terrible condition, you know, but the canopy's looking like shit. We don't need to get sunburned. Look at all these buffalo. We're gonna kill them. A herd of bison blocks the trail ahead. They mill about aimless and unconcerned by humanity as they are obstructive to its passage. If given enough time, the herd is sure to move on eventually as grazing opportunities pass. However, there is no telling how long that may take. The herd could also be scared into moving with a gunshot, or perhaps this is the opportunity to hunt for supplies. I don't want to stampede. But that could also be the same thing if I try to scare them with a gunshot. We're okay for food, so let's go ahead and wait. Settle down and wait for them to move along. How long will this take? They wait for some time, but the herd still lingers. Well, I'm just gonna shoot one of you then. Who should fire the shot? Ambrose, I guess. Please don't get gored. I don't like that something. His aim is poor, missing the bison entirely. However, the gun's report shook the herd, and they begin to stampede. With the herd gone, we can continue. Lewis and Clark. Oh, here's the hunting ground, okay. Now that his energy is full, he should be able to carry quite a bit back. You know, assuming we don't get screwed by rocks and bushes. shitting. You know, I'm a little confused why the deer sound like horses. I don't believe they do. Oh my god, get the damn bison. Nah, they're gonna get away. Alright. How much do you carry back, my friend? I guess 150 is the max. We are going to definitely see about obtaining those pelts. We get 8. Boom. Campsite. We could tell more stories, and we could rest. We're gonna go ahead and do it. We're good on food and stuff. We need to change out. Oh no, it's gonna be the last of the clothes. Evie, because she's messy. I'm gonna go ahead and change Ambrose's because he tends to do a lot of stuff. Like the carpentry and the hunting a lot. So I assume he's gonna get dirtier than David. Evie spies something in the long grass of the plains. It appears to be a crate. Although one scuffed around the edges and slightly cracked, it may have fallen off of some wagon long past. Someone may need us more than us. What should we do? After the crate is pried open, it is revealed to contain 149 pounds of flour and a couple of doses of medicine. What should be done? Yeah, but it's potentially old. We're gonna take the medicine. I don't trust old food. Oh, come on, Evie. It's an old crate. Get over yourself and your damn altruism. Party transfers the supplies to a wagon. Some of them may feel it would have been more cherishable to leave them behind for future travelers. Yeah, well, we left them the food. How about that? Hey, if we didn't... I mean, whatever. I'm not even gonna go there anymore. We're gonna set up camp. I believe our energy levels are still good, yeah. So we're just gonna tell stories to each other. Keep on improving ourselves. I'm gonna go ahead and get to wherever the next location is. And then that's where we can stop. We're almost departing of the way, so we'll be there soon. And then we'll actually end the episode. Rabbits. Man, I got a feeling something's gonna happen before we get there, and it's not gonna be good. Evie begins scratching. Oh, it's this. Well, we'll treat it with the bacon grease again. We got plenty of food. She's comfortable again. Good. There's a spot that is about to F off. I thought it was saying something was there. Whatever. Okay. And here we are. Looks like the dip before we go into the mountains. And here's the split. Though no one had so much as noticed the gradual ascent, the party has arrived at the summit of the Rocky Mountains, the very backbone of the North American continent. Alright, I can leave it here. Yeah, we'll pick it up next time. See you later.